Thank you. We discussed about sin because we're talking about repentance. If you want to clearly understand repentance, you have to clearly understand sin. Okay. Is this better? Okay, thank you. Okay, now as we discussed, repentance basic principles are this. First, you have to realize that you're a sinner. Number two, you have to be sorry for your sins. And you have to confess your sins. You have to ask for forgiveness, and then you need to come back to God. So today we will be talking about the first principle of repentance, which is realizing that I am a sinner. Okay? So today's message title is Realizing That I Am a Sinner. Now, the passage we're going to be reading today is Mark, Book of Mark. So if you could get out your Bible, your phone apps. Mark chapter 6. Mark chapter 6, verses 53 to 56. Mark chapter 6, 53 to 56. Okay. So, I'll start reading, you guys could follow along, okay? When they had crossed over, they landed at Gennesaret and anchored there. As soon as they got out of the boat, people recognized Jesus. They ran throughout the whole region and carried the sick on mats to wherever they heard he was. And wherever he went, into villages, towns, or countryside, they placed the sick in the marketplace. They begged him to let them touch even the edge of his cloak, and all who touched it were healed. Amen. Today's passage tells us that when Jesus came, people throughout the whole entire region came out and brought the sick to Jesus Christ. It seems that anyone and everyone who is sick or knew somebody who was sick came to Jesus. With those sick. If you've ever been sick, if you have family members, relatives, friends who have sicknesses, you could totally relate to these people. You spend countless hours trying to be healed. You go to hospital, but things just don't get any better. There doesn't seem to be a cure. And you hear, hey, there's this person who miraculously heals people. What would you do? For me, if I my son or my wife was sick, it doesn't matter where that person is in the world, I would go there. To be healed of the sickness that is in you is beyond any price for people who are without cure hope without hope. But now, I want you to think about it on the flip side. I wonder how many people came to Jesus who weren't sick. You know, I guess some people could just casually come, just out of curiosity, to see if this man could actually perform miracles. Let me just check it out. Back then, they didn't have any YouTube. You needed to go check it out yourself. But how many would come in real sincerity and true genuineness? You know, when we read this passage, there's no record of such people. Only people that it mentioned is people who were sick that were brought. So, let me ask you a question today, all of you. Are you sick or are you well? Or are you sick or are you well? Jimin? You don't have to answer. Joon, it's good to have you here. Think about it, everyone. Think about yourself. Am I sick or am I well? Are you like one of the sick in today's passage who are desperately coming to Jesus Christ? Or are you one of those who consider themselves well, who have no need for Jesus Christ? Did you come to worship this morning because you need the healing hand of Jesus? Or did you come just to observe how Jesus heals those guys who are obviously sick? Are you casually here or are you desperate? Well, if you are here to be healed, I know that Jesus will touch your heart and heal you. And if you are here just as an observer, I pray that God will touch your heart so that you will realize actually your sickness. That you realize that you need a healer and a savior. Because as we read in Romans chapter 3, there's no